Here's the map. See what you can make of it. So, where do you think it is? Qingzi Village. I don't see the resemblance at all. How'd you come to that conclusion? Oh. Okay, then. I'm definitely a rookie at this. But your word's good enough for me. Time for a trip to Qingzi. You're coming with me, of course. I'll need you to help me zero in on the specific location once we're there.
Ah, Pedro! Wow, and the traveler! My goodness, what's the occasion? Just here to visit us old folks once again? It hasn't been all that long since we last had a visit from the Crux. But I'm glad you picked today. You're just the people I need. These two young rascals. They've been arguing with each other non-stop about some petty nonsense or other. I'm too old to get through to them. They won't listen to me. Please, talk some sense into them.
Rest assured, Granny Zhuoxin. Whatever the situation is, the Traveler and I will take care of it.
Oh, thank goodness! It's Captain Beidou! You couldn't have come at a better time! You're the voice of reason I need in this situation!
Captain, please! Help me get justice!
Whoa, hey! What exactly is going on here? Spit it out, tell me everything!
It makes me mad just talking about it. G here? I don't know if he's got a screw loose or what his problem is. But anyway, he took it upon himself to raise, well, practically a whole army of finches, okay? And now guess what? They fly onto my land and completely destroy at least half of my crops. I asked him to pay compensation, but he refused. Now how is that fair?
Captain, I'm innocent. They're not even my finches. I just thought they looked kinda cute, you know? So I fed them a couple of times. They're wild birds, though.
A couple times? Are you kidding me? That's rich. Really rich. There were two of them when you first started. Two finches. Now you have a whole roof full of finch nests. I swear, every time I come by your place, I think I'm at a bird market. I'm telling you, you are not gonna get away with this anymore.
So, yeah. I mean, they laid a few eggs, made a few nests, but finches gotta finch, you know. These are wild birds. I mean, they'll do whatever they please.
So that's how it is. I think I got the picture. What's your take? Yeah, you have a point. Gee, let's say I'm interested in buying these finches off you. What would you say to that?
Are you serious, Captain? Oh, that would be great! Honestly, with all this trouble they've been causing me lately, they've become a bit of a burden. So if you're happy to take them off my hands, that would be perfect.
Alright, deal. My only condition is, you have to use some of the money to compensate Wen Jing for her losses.
Oh, come on. But I never raised them, did I?
Well, you tell me. You took my deal, that means you admitted to being the owner, doesn't it? Otherwise, what gives you the right to sell them to me?
Captain Beidou's right! If you didn't raise them, what makes you think you can go taking her money for them, huh?
Well...
Don't worry. My offer includes plenty left over for you after deducting the compensation. This way, you get something back for looking after them.
Okay then, okay. I'll pay the compensation.
I hope you two are very grateful indeed to Beidou. I dare say no one else will be quite so accommodating toward the people of our village.
Granny Zhuoxin, as you know, many of the boys from your fine village do sterling work for the Crux. The fleet wouldn't be what it is today without them, so please think nothing of it. Ji, Wenjing, I guess you're free to go.
Captain Beidou! Captain Beidou, you're here!
Pop Xing! It's been a long time. How have you been?
Don't get me started. I've been having some real trouble with that neighbor of mine, Zhen. We keep having the same argument, and it just goes nowhere. I heard you were in the village, so I rushed over to seek your help.
What's the issue?
Oh, come with me. You'll see. Let's go find Zhen and clear this whole thing up, face to face.
Huh?
Captain Beidou, you're here.
I heard that you and Pop Xing had a little misunderstanding. So, what's up? Tell me about it.
Zhen planted a tree on his property a few years back. I had no issue with it at the time. It's just a tree. But a few years on, it's grown taller than the roof of my house. Every morning when I get up and open the window, I just want to feel the sun on my face, but I'm greeted instead by the looming shadow of my neighbor's tree. It really affects my mood. I asked Zhen to cut it down so I could get some sunlight back on my property, but he said no. It's like he's done this on purpose just to drive me crazy.
Captain Beidou, you gotta believe me. I didn't intend to block the sunlight, but there's nothing I can do about it now. It's not just any old tree, you see. That tree was planted there by my late father. Not long after he planted it, he passed away. And just before he passed, he left me with some parting words. He said our family's fortune was inauspicious and we needed something to suppress the bad luck. That's what he planted the tree for. How can I just chop it down? I'll be honest, I spent a few years studying in Liyue Harbor, so I don't actually share his superstitious beliefs. But still, that doesn't change the fact that this was my father's dying wish.
Okay, I think I'm all clear on the situation. What are you thinking? I was thinking along the same lines as you. Look, Pops, I'm not trying to make excuses for Zhen, but just try putting yourself in his shoes for a moment. Zhen's desire to protect his tree isn't for money or because he wants to hurt anyone, or for the sake of any superstition. He just wants to honor his father's dying wish. Pops, you have kids too, right?
Yeah. When you put it like that...
Pops, if you can agree to it, I'll have a word with Granny Zhuoxin and see about getting you some money from the relief fund as compensation for having your sunlight blocked. As for the tree...
That sounds good to me. Whatever you think, Captain Beidou, the tree can stay. Some compensation would make me feel much better about the whole thing.
Thank you, Captain Beidou. And thank you for understanding, Pops Xing. I'll make sure to trim it back when I get home to let some more light through. It'll be such a relief not to have to worry about this anymore. On a separate note, I remember the Crux last visited the village not very long ago. Is there some special reason why you're back in person so soon?
Nothing all that special, just personal reasons. I'm looking for some treasure.
Huh? Treasure? Wait a second. That reminds me, I saw Chongping and Defu arguing in the fields earlier. It sounded like they were both trying to lay claim to some treasure. I don't know if it's related to the one you're looking for, but anyway, they're probably still there now.
Really? Okay, well, you and Pop Xing can go about your business now. I'll go see what the situation is.
Huh? Beto, you're just in time. Defu's being completely unreasonable.
What happened?
I'm not being unreasonable, Captain. I got Chunqing to help me plow my land because it's the busy season. And then, what do you know, he plows up a treasure chest. The way I see it, it's my land, so the treasure belongs to me, right? I think it's a pretty clear-cut case.
You say that, Defu, but what you're forgetting is that I came to help you plow your fields out of the goodness of my heart, and you haven't paid me a single mora. It was also my plowing that turned up this chest. However you cut it, surely I'm entitled to at least some of the treasure.
The domestic drama just keeps coming today. What are your thoughts? Okay, I think I'm up to speed here. If you two really want to take this further, I can get a legal expert from Liyue Harbor to adjudicate. As for the costs, I'll cover them. What do you think? Neither of you seems thrilled about this course of action. Okay, so, plan B. I'll be straight with you. The reason I came here today was to look for some treasure. Chances are it's hiding right there in the chest you're both fighting over. So, how about you two stop fighting over it and do me a favor by handing it to me? Of course, I'll be indebted to both of you. If either of you ever needs anything in the future, the Crux will not hesitate to lend you our support.
Captain, you're far too kind, really. Indebted? That won't be necessary. If you want this chest, you go ahead and take it.
Yep, totally agree. If only I'd known you were looking for this chest. You should have said something. I would have delivered it to you personally to save you the trip.
It seems like it's been quite a busy day for you, helping us settle all our little quarrels. Come on, let's go to the village. I'll rally the masses. We'll get some good food and good drink and have a good old get-together.
Don't worry about the chest. I'll carry it over.
What a fine day today has been. Beto has solved an awful lot of problems in our village.
She sure has. Without Captain Beto, that compensation payment would have bankrupted me.
Yeah, and if it weren't for Captain Beto, I'd still be arguing with Pops Xing.
Hear, hear! We have plenty to thank Captain Beto for, I'm sure. I propose a toast in her honor.
To Captain Beto. Cheers!
I couldn't ask for more than the chance to get everyone together and drink to our heart's content. Cheers! Whew, that really hit the spot. Want to get some air? The view in this place is pretty good. We can take a look through the contents of that chest while we're at it. Chunqing placed it by the water wheel. Are you kidding? Beto can handle her liquor. Come on, let's go. So, I've been thinking. Everyone seems to trust me enough to let me have the final word on their disputes. But don't you think some of my solutions can be a little stupid? You can laugh, I don't mind. Take Chunqing and Defu's wrangling over that chest, for instance. I had no clue who it should belong to, so I just came up with this stupid idea of taking it for myself. At least that way, neither of them would feel like it was unfair. But, I mean, I'm no Ningguang. I can't make a perfect deal every time. And I'm no Yunfei either. Not all my judgment calls are going to be 100% fair and square. I am Beidou, and my strength is in trading favors. You think I should be more selective? Some people think their favors are so valuable that they need to plan out how and when to use them to maximize the return on their investment. They view the favor as a bargaining chip. Others see doing favors as a burden, not worth anything in monetary terms and prone to getting you locked in a cycle of constantly returning the favor back and forth. But the way I see it, favors are what keep people connected to one another. Over thousands of years, the people of Liyue have created bonds between each other by doing someone a favor here and asking for a favor there. This means that no individual is truly on their own out there. When someone falls down, there's an invisible net made of human connections, waiting to catch them and get them back on their feet. Over the years, I've come to owe favors to a great many people, and many other people have come to owe me one. These are the countless bonds between us, like so many fish in the sea. And they're the reason that the Crux and I have survived the countless hardships we faced. I believe that if there ever comes a day when the world is overrun by monsters, Liyue's legal system collapses and the land is thrust back into an age of war, it's these bonds that will see us all through the dark days ahead, until we come out on the other side. I'm not saying that. But either way, we have a pretty firm bond between us already, don't you think? Was this wind brewed in a winery? It's making me lightheaded. I feel like I'm forgetting something. Something we were literally just talking about. Oh, yeah, the chest! Oh, I got so immersed in our conversation that I forgot all about the main event. Come on, let's open it up and see what's inside. Oh, that's it? A whole lot of nothing? It's not exactly what I was looking for, but you know what? I don't care. The fun part was going on a treasure hunt with you. Come on, let's get back to the party. Tonight, we go big before we go home.